SwiftUI ScrollViews in iOS 18 have taken user interface design to a new level with enhanced performance, smoother interactions, and powerful new features. The ability to create dynamic, content-rich scrollable areas has never been easier or more efficient. In this tutorial, we'll dive deep into these exciting new updates, offering step-by-step guidance on how to implement them, making this video the go-to resource for iOS developers looking to master the latest ScrollView capabilities in iOS 18. This video is the first in a two-part series about new enhancements in ScrollViews in SwiftUI / iOS 18. Now, this is really amazing. Today, we are going to talk about scroll position. And next up in the next video, make sure to check out the link in the description for the playlist. In the next video, we are going to talk about scroll phases, which is a brand new API, and it enables a lot of power to us developers regarding the SwiftUI ScrollView. Now, these tutorials are a small part what we are going to learn in SwiftUI Camp. If you want to learn SwiftUI in 4 weeks, actually master SwiftUI in 4 weeks, go ahead and check out the link in the description for an 80% off for the free left seats. We are going to start soon on the week of the 14th of October. And go ahead and check it out. We are having 4 weeks, the basics, scrollable, views, and navigation. And this video is kind of the part of a week free scroll views. Okay, so let me just show you the Xcode project that I have prepared. So basically we are having some data, red, blue, green, all of that stuff. And then inside the content view, we are having a tab view with two views. One is the scroll position view and the other one is scroll phase view. This is what we are going to talk about next in the next video. In the scroll position view, let me just go there, scroll position view, we are actually having just a simple scroll view with a for each going through all of the colors. There we go. And the navigation title and these three buttons. So this is what we are going to implement today. And make sure to check out the whole video, because at the end, I am going to give you a really nice treat. You know, chat applications. Oh, take a look at the whole video. Okay, so in the next one, again, it's kind of a scroll view right over here with the colors again, but we are going to talk about scroll phases. If you don't know what I'm talking about, make sure again to check out the next video. It is going to come out next week. So today, scroll position. Let's just have a little bit more right over here. So what is the end goal for the scroll position thing in SwiftUI? Well, you usually want to scroll your scroll view manually, going to a certain cell. So that could be the last one right over here, or it could be some, I don't know, maybe the purple one. So you want to show one at a certain place, one cell. How could you do that? Well, previously in SwiftUI, previous versions of SwiftUI, you needed to embed your scroll view into a scroll geometry, and then you want to grab its proxy, and the proxy had a scroll to ID property. You needed to set up your cells with those IDs, and then you needed to scroll to that ID. Anyway, it was kind of tedious. If you wanted to scroll all the way down, you still had to do the ID way. Now we have some more convenience. It's really, really simple. We are going to add that. We are going to scroll up automatically. Also, we are going to scroll down to the bottom of the scroll view. And we're also going to show you how you can scroll to a certain ID. So let's start off with the new scroll position variable. We are going to add it right over here. It's a state variable. So we have our scroll position. Now with this, we can do a lot of stuff. So first of all, we need to link this scroll position to a certain scroll view. I'm just going to add it right over here. Dot scroll position. And that is dollar sign scroll position. We're actually binding it to our scroll position view modifier. And we are all set. Now we can just simply use it. Let's just go down over here to our button. Let's just have a little bit more space. So I want to scroll up. And for that, we just grab our scroll position dot. And there is this scroll to function. We may scroll to X, Y, to a certain edge, to a point, X and Y, ID, and an anchor. Anchor is just bottom leading trailing on top. So of the set. X and Y, you know, scroll views, they are not just vertical, like in my example. You may go to a certain point. Yeah, you might have that use case. But the easiest way of using this, and this is what we are going to add right over here, is the edge one. So you may have bottom, leading, top, and trailing. Because this is basically a vertical scroll view, I'm just going to select top. Let's just see that. I'm just going to scroll down a little bit and then tap right over here. It just jumped actually right over up to my first cell, to the top of the scroll view. Now, this is jumpy. I want this to be really like scrolling like we have right over here, not just jumping all the way up to the red. So what I'm going to do is just add width animation. And then put that scroll position scroll to into the width animation. Okay, let's just see that. Let's scroll down a little bit. And now it's just smoothly scrolling all the way up. SwiftUI Camp is your ultimate solution for rapidly boosting your SwiftUI skills, offering an immersive and practical learning experience in just 4 weeks. You will explore crucial topics such as creating views, handling data, using Codable, and navigating effectively, all through engaging Zoom sessions. This bootcamp is tailored to fast-track your progress with hands-on projects and real-time guidance, setting you on the path to becoming a SwiftUI expert in no time. Find more details in the link below. Now, I also want to scroll down, so let me just copy this out and paste it in there. Now, the edge will be actually bottom. Okay, I'm at the top right now. Let's just click on this button and it just scrolled all the way down. Finally, I want to scroll to a certain position. Let's just go for the purple one. And if we take a look at the app data, the purple one is actually at index 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm just going to set up the ID to be at index 5. Let me just show you where we set up the ID. So the ID is basically the color itself. If you have an identifiable, you want to set the ID of the cell, the color, you know, the actual item that you are passing into the for each. We have ID self right over here, so this is not required, but if you are not having that ID, it's inferred with the identifiable, you must add ID right over here for the color, because we are going to use the color to jump to that ID. So I'm just going to copy out the width animation right over here, and then the scroll to, let's just have a little bit more space, the scroll to ID is what we are going to use. And we actually need a hashable. So yeah, you want to have the colors are hashable and sendable. So want to make sure that your model is not just identifiable or codable, you want to make it hashable too. So I'm just going to go app data and then colors. And I'm just going to go with the fifth one as we discussed. So I just wanted to jump to the purple one. So let's just go all the way down. And there we go. The purple has, you know, it's revealed. That's the whole point. We see it on the screen. It's appeared on the view. And that's it. If you just scroll all the way up, there we go. Already down. And you just click on the button again. The purple will appear. Now, final thing, which is really, really amazing. I left this to the end of the video. This is really, really cool. Let's say you are developing a chat application. Now, scrolling always to the bottom was really, really hard. What you could do is just add one simple view modifier. And the data is the same. You know, we have this red, blue, green, all of the colors. The last one, maybe the last message, is this gray color. So what do you have to do in order to not start your view like this, as it did previously, you already saw that, but at the bottom. So you want to add to the actual scroll view, so here we go, all the way down to the scroll view, you want to add default scroll anchor. This is so amazing. Default scroll anchor. And you want to set this to either top, bottom, center, leading, whatever. In our case, I'm just going to go for the bottom. And there you go. It just starts off at the bottom, which is really, really amazing. Now, if this is a chat application, when you add a new message, you are going to also animate the scroll position to the edge of bottom after message has been added to the scroll view. And that's how easy it is. If you tried building a chat interface previously with SwiftUI, most probably you had a lot of trouble. I know, I've been there. It's really, really complicated. But with this new API, with the scroll position, it's a breeze. Now, this is what we learned and so much more in SwiftUI Camp. Go ahead and check it out. The link for an 80% off is down in the description. Only 3 seats left. I don't know, when you are watching this, maybe even less. Go ahead and check it out. It's SwiftUI Camp. The link is down in the description. I hope to see you in there.